Premio Nonino 2022, Maestri del nostro tempo, a Nancy Fraser.
Well, I'm so, so happy and pleased to be here, so honored to receive this prize. I have to tell you that while I was traveling here for this very happy occasion, I received a very unhappy surprise. I learned that a document leaked to the press reveals that a majority of justices on the United States Supreme Court are preparing to overturn the right to abortion. That is, they would overturn Roe v. Wade, the famous historic 1973 ruling, which established a woman's liberty to choose to have an abortion unhampered by excessive government restriction. The effect of this change, if it happens, will be to nullify a fundamental right, one that has been entrenched in the United States for a full 50 years. Well, this leaked document already is a major debacle, even in advance of any actual ruling. The leak has invalidated the court's claim to be above politics, and it has thrown the court's legitimacy into question. That is yet another blow to a democratic system, the American system, which is already in tatters, tarnished not only by longstanding structural racism and voter suppression, but by more recent uncertainties about whether election results will be respected and whether peaceful transitions of power will actually occur. At another level, the leaked draft shows that even in liberal democracies, the fundamental rights of women are insecure. Such rights, we see, can be withdrawn in an instant. Their preservation requires ongoing efforts from social movements, from intellectuals, from unions, professional associations, community organizations, political parties, citizens in general. But this debacle also extends to a deeper level. If it turns back the clock on women's rights, the court will open the way to other reversals on LGBTQ rights, on trans rights, on racial, ethnic, and gender discrimination, on civil liberties more broadly. These rights are intended to protect the personal autonomy of individuals and equal freedom for all. Their history extends all the way back to the medieval period, to ideals of freedom of conscience, and to the congiuratio of the Italian city-states, where serfs fleeing feudal domination sought refuge. So, the American court is threatening to abort a centuries-long history of moral and legal revolution. That history has taught us that liberal freedom requires social and political equality. Rights on paper cannot become real freedoms without the material means that are needed to exercise them and without the equal political voice that is needed to formulate them. What does the right to abortion mean if there exist no clinics that provide it, or if there is no insurance coverage to pay for it? How can abortion be a genuine choice without guaranteed income support and childcare provision? How can it be an equal right for all in the absence of broad, effective policies to overcome poverty and racism? It is for reasons like these that the moral revolution aimed at securing freedom became a social and political revolution in the 20th century. The question of freedom also looms at the international level, where the principles of equal autonomy and justice apply as well. We are all aware of the horrific events unfolding only a few hundred miles from here right now, and we understand the principle of national autonomy, which is at stake in Ukraine. But it is also the case that national autonomy must include principles of individual freedom, of social justice, and equal political voice, including for women and for national minorities. In terms articulated by the philosopher Jürgen Habermas, personal autonomy and public autonomy are co-original, two sides of the same coin. Given the news from the United States and the news from Russia and Eastern Europe, I must confess that I've come here with mixed emotions. As I said, I'm deeply honored to receive the Nonino Prize, and I'm truly happy to participate in this celebration of the power of art and ideas. But I am at the same time struck by the fragility of our freedoms and by the all too real chance that we will lose them. Thank you.